Hi everyone, it's Praveen here. This video is about best portable projectors. Well, at number 5 is GV1, which weighs only 700 gram. It can be compared to a size of a cool drink tin in a square shape. It supports full HD resolution, but still the picture quality can only be said as not that bad, as its original output resolution is only 480 pixels and it misses out details in the darker scenes or images. For an example, can be said as these projectors will be good if used in a 12 by 10 feet sized rooms in a low light conditions. Picture quality will look better when connected through power adapter. While in battery, if it is in power saving mode, it reduces the brightness and helps to work for extra few minutes in a fully charged condition. GV1 has auto vertical keystone adjustments even if you tilt upwards or place it straight. And for screen focus, we need to do it manually. Inbuilt speaker sound is not that great if you are a bit away from the unit. For example, it can be compared with a laptop speaker, but GV1 has some additional bass in it. If you are like a heavy sound guy, then definitely an external speaker is needed. In terms of connectivity, it has Wi-Fi and Bluetooth and only one Type-C port as input. So you need to have Type-C adapters to connect with USB or HDMI, and it can directly play media files from external storage device. It works better with iOS phones, and for Android, you will need to install Google Home app for better experience, and your screen can be mirrored. Check for display port functionality in your phones. Only then these options will work. It has Netflix, YouTube and Hotstar as streaming apps, but Amazon Prime is not available. And due to content protection, some subscription based apps will be restricted, but still you can mirror image from laptop. Apollo supports full HD resolution, but still the picture quality is considered as okay, as its output quality is only 480 pixels and its brightness is okay for a normal sized room in a low light condition. Choose standard image mode in the settings for full brightness. If not, power saver mode will reduce the brightness and then your picture quality also will get reduced. Apollo can automatically adjust vertical keystones, and for horizontal we have to adjust manually using inbuilt settings by the remote control. Screen focus have to be done manually as well. Inbuilt speaker is decent, won't be great enough if you are a bit away from the unit, as dialogues won't be heard clearly, whereas music will be in high tone. Hence, an external speaker will be needed. The touchpad on top feel very easy to use, like a cursor. In terms of connectivity, it has Wi-Fi and Bluetooth for wireless connections, and for wired, it has HDMI and USB, and it can directly play media files from external storage device. Apollo has a Nebula Connect app for both iOS and Android mobiles. Screen mirroring is easier, but copyright content cannot be mirrored based on the subscriptions. Apollo almost works same like a Fire Stick. Mogo weighs around 1 kg and is a bit larger than Apollo in size. The quality of picture is really good, even though it is of 540 pixels. It can support up to 4K resolution at a stretch of 4 hours with its inbuilt battery life. Mogo has both vertical and horizontal keystone adjustments, but horizontal has to be done manually in the settings. Mogo claims as it has 10,000 plus autofocus points, which ensures the entire screen is fully focused at all times. But I am not sure about 10,000 focus points, but the screen looks sharper always. Harman Kardon built in dual speakers where well fine-tuned, hence the quality of music is top-notch, and it can be connected through 3.5mm audio pin and by Bluetooth. It can be used as Bluetooth speaker as well. Remote control has voice command, which makes things easier to operate. In terms of connectivity, it has Wi-Fi and Bluetooth as standard with one USB, HDMI and a 3.5mm audio. By using File Manager app, it can directly access and play media files directly from the external storage device. It has Android TV app, and some subscription based apps will be restricted. For this price range, Mogo really serves good. Almost everything in it functions as a portable smart TV. This global youth version is heavier, weighing around 1.3 kgs. It has an excellent image projection quality and it supports 4K resolution as well. Brightness level is not that great, even though it is of 500 lumens. It has no batteries in it. It works directly with power supply by an adapter. It has autofocus, but with some focusing issue, as we have to adjust the focus for the second time either in the middle of the movie. And once the second time is done, then there will be no such issues again. The built-in Dolby and DTS enabled speaker sounds really good and decently loud, hence no external speaker is needed, and it can also be used as a Bluetooth speaker as well. In terms of connectivity, it has Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, then followed by USB, HDMI and a 3.5mm jack. It has Android TV app with certain restrictions as other portable projectors also have. And if you don't mind about power cable connected to the projector always, then close your eyes and pick up this. It really worth for the price you pay. LG PH550 is actually an old model, but still it's an all-rounder in portable category. It weighs only 650 gram, handy and easy to carry. It supports full HD, but its original resolution itself is 720 pixels. Which is really good for a portable projector. Some more, it has 550 lumens, which is really bright, but not as bright as a standard home theater projector, but still, we can say it's bright for its size. The picture quality is really good among these projectors, and the battery life of this will be about 2.5 hours. It has auto vertical keystone and a manual screen focusing slider on top. Inbuilt speaker volume will be very low, so it's better to have an external speaker. The best part in this projector is its connectivity options. It has HDMI, USB, VGA, 3.5mm audio and video in, audio out, and a TV tuner to connect with antennas, and also with Bluetooth and Wi-Fi connection. It can directly play video from external storage device, and it also has 3D optimizer. Hence, with the DLP 3D glasses, you can enjoy 3-dimensional movies. Hence, these are the 5 products which I came across with under the price range of 30,000 to 50,000 Indian rupees. These products are chosen based on the availability in online websites, and its links will be in the description below. Please stay subscribed for the next video of mini portable projectors. Thank you.